Hello, everyone. Stephanie coming at you with a 30-minute total body workout. So maybe you're a little bit pressed for time. You want to get everything going. We're going to do that together today. So we will start on one yellow spring. This is going to be reformer friendly. If you need a little more support off the front of the machine, you can pop that second yellow on. Checking your spring load, we start with a full body warm up in a catfish. So hands come to the high bars. Feet are on number three, little bend to the elbows, shoulders down and back. Back is nice and flat. You press out, one, two, three, four. Beautiful. Lifting up and in from that lower core as you pull yourself in. Gorgeous. Keeping the back nice and flat, little bend into the elbows. Let the lats and triceps ignite as you pull up and in, as you press it out. Two, three, four. Beautiful. We are going to incorporate a little bit of upper body. Coming into a push-up option, right? If it's not for you today, it's all good. Just let everything flow together. Beautiful. Lift up and in. Let that lower core pull you in. Press you out. One, two, three, four. Take it down. Press it up. Little bend to the elbows. Lift up and in through that lower core. Beautiful. Nice flat back. Let it all happen together. Total body warm up here. Zip up through the inner thighs. Gorgeous. Hands are coming down to that front platform. We hold the plank in four, in three, in two, and one. So bring those hands down to the front platform. Little bend into the elbows. Knees bend in right underneath the hips for a bear. For one, for two, three, four, little 1 second hold, you press it out. Two, three, four, beautiful. Lift it up and in. Use that lower core. Gorgeous, knee stop right underneath the hips. Elbow, shoulder stay aligned. Give that tiny bend into the elbows. Let the lower core pull you up and in. Beautiful. Press it out. Two, three, four. Start feeling all of that energy throughout the body here. As you press in, as you press back out, beautiful. Zip up through those inner thighs. Feel that lower core ignite. Gorgeous. Forearms come down. Shins come down. Nice. In four, three, two, one. Bring the shins down to the carriage. Bring the forearms down to that front platform. Press out, hold. Elbows, shoulders align. We lift through the core, kneeling crunch in three, in two, and one. It's up, two, three, four. You press out, two, three, four. Beautiful. So we go into that kneeling crunch here. You press down through the forearms. You press down through the shins. Lift up through that core. As that carriage comes in, keep a little distance in between the carriage and the platform. Lifting up, two, three, four. Press out, two, three, four. Beautiful. We're gonna take a little saw combo. So on your next one, as you hold out, take a moment here. Now hinge from the shoulders. One, two, three, four. Pull in. Two, three, four. Take the crunch. Beautiful. Knee stop right underneath the hips. Press it out. Two, three, four. Gorgeous. Take that saw. Pressing up and in. Nice. Gorgeous job, guys. We got a hold over the well. In four, three, two, and one. Press out over the well. Come into your saw hold no matter where you are, right? Now press down through those forearms. Press down through the shins. When you connect the shins with the carriage, you feel more energy into your lower core. We take it to full range in three, two, one. Pull in, take it into your crunch. You got 10 seconds here. We will take this into a baby cobra. You'll press down through the forearms. You'll press down through the palms. We lift the forearms in four, in three, two, and one. So stabilize yourself. Elbow, shoulders aligned. Press down through the palms. Lift the forearms up. One, up two, three, four. Little bend to the elbows. Take it down. Two, three, four. Beautiful. Lift. Let the lats and triceps ignite. Little bend into those elbows. Press down through those shins. As soon as you connect those shins, right, you start feeling that energy from that lower core. Beautiful. Take it down. Two, three, four. Press up. Two, three, four. Little bend into those elbows. Gorgeous. Total body squats. You're going to make a spring change. We're going into a heavy leg series. Beautiful. One red, two yellow. If you're on a reformer, it's probably going to be a blue and two yellow. In three, two, and one. So make your heavy spring load change. Change your springs coming into a squat. Left foot's going to go underneath the platform strap. Right foot's going to go underneath the carriage strap. Press out. Take a heavy squat. Take it down for one. Down two. Three. And four. Beautiful. Drive up through those heels. Now, you press that carriage out. You start feeling that sauce in the outer glutes. As you start driving up and down, through the legs, let the heels connect. Right? So then you get into the back of the legs. Tiniest bend into the knees as you come up. Beautiful. Little bend. Take it down. Two, three, four. Every time you go down into that squat, really challenge yourself to sit down a little bit deeper. Press it up. Little bend to the knees. You take it down. Two, three, four. You press up. Gorgeous. Little bend. Nice. We got a hold coming up. In four, three, two, and one. Take it down. Hold. Drive through the heels. Sit yourself back. Beautiful. Now, come up just 1 inch. Yeah. Feel that energy through the back of the legs. Gorgeous. We press up together. In four, in three, two, one. Press up. Two, three, four. Beautiful. Take it down. Two, three, four. Awesome. We come into skater. You sit down into that squat hold. In four, in three, two, one. Beautiful. Sit down into that squat hold. Hands can come to the high bars or they can be behind your back. We press that right leg out. Left leg stabilizes. It's for one, two, three, four. Beautiful. You want to take it about 98% of the way. That's what I always say, right? And then pull it back in. Beautiful. Keep that distance in between the carriage and the platform. So I'm going to talk about constant tension if you're a little bit newer with us. Everything that we do here is for time, not reps. You want to actually do the least amount of reps during your segment, right? So the slower you move, that's where all the magic's going to happen here. Drive through that left heel, right heel presses out, little bend into that knee. You take it in, two, three, four, press out, two, three, four, beautiful. Awesome job, guys. Holding onto those high bars, if you need a little bit of support, I always think it helps me sit down just a little bit deeper as you press out. Two, three, four, you pull in. Nice. Really start driving through that left heel. The magic happens in the outer glutes a little bit more when you are pigeon-toed for this. So make sure that the heels press out and the toes turn in. Gorgeous. Pressing out. Two, three, and four. You pull in. Nice. So we're coming into a runner's lunge. Left foot's going to stay under that platform strap. Right foot's going to come to the front of your carriage. We'll set up for a runner's lunge. Now we'll get into that middle glute. Beautiful. In four, in three, in two, and one. So turn towards the front of the room. Left foot's on the left side of the front platform. Right foot is going to press against the front of your carriage. If you have a carriage strap, you can press into that as well. Take two 90-degree angles and take a hold here. Drive through that left heel, let it connect to that front platform. Right leg's gonna press out in three, in two, and one. It's out for one, out two, out three, out four. You pull in two, three, four. Knee stops underneath the hip, press out. Two, three, and four. You pull in now. Once you're here, start feeling that sauce even in that right oblique, right? As you press out through the right foot, left leg is still the leg that's working here, but you press out through the right foot. Feel that right oblique ignite. Two, three, and four. Beautiful. Press it in. Two, three, and four. Awesome. Keep that nice slow pace here. Shoulders are down and back. Now, you give a little bend into the elbows, right? If you're using the high bars, I always suggest having something to ground your upper body down with, because I find that when people like to do this in a runner's lunge, they start floating out of it, and that misses the entire point. Sit it down, press it out. We got a hold in three, two, one. Take the two 90 degree angle holds. Drive through your left heel. Sit down just one more inch. Here's your new starting point. We press out in three, in two, and one. You press one, two, three, four. Beautiful. We're going into a little bit of heavy upper body. You'll kneel on the carriage. It's called a chest press. Feet will go into the back eyelets or against your shoulder rest. Hands will come to the edge of the high bars. Beautiful. Finish out strong here in four. Chest press, three, two, and one. Close that carriage up. Kneel on the carriage, feet go into the back eyelets. Press into the eyelets either your high bars or you have that one high bar to take your hands towards the edge. Now bend at the elbows. Elbows come out to the sides. You want a beautiful diagonal line from the top of your head through your knees. Arms are only going to two 90 degree angles, and then you press away. Pull it in, two, three, four. You press out, beautiful. Two, three, four. Little bend into those elbows, gorgeous. Pressing out. Once you have that nice diagonal line, you'll feel your lower and middle core working a little more. Give a little squeeze through the inner thighs. Beautiful, pressing out. Two, three, four, you pull in, yes. Right to 290 degree angle. So, coming into our right leg. We'll start with the squats first. Left foot, right foot goes underneath that platform strap. Left foot goes underneath the carriage strap. Heavy squats in four, in three, two, and one. Close that carriage up. Right foot goes underneath the platform strap this time. Left foot goes underneath the carriage strap. Press that carriage out just a tiny bit. Sit yourself back into the squat. Once you're here, we take it up for one, up two, three, four. Tiniest bend into the knees. Take it down. Two, three, and four. So you just start with those heavy squats, right? Because I want you to feel the drive through the heels, the pull up through the back of the legs. Inner and outer thighs are actually stabilizing you here as you take it down. Two, three, four. You press up, little bend. Oh yeah. Gorgeous. We take it into that hold in a few short seconds, right? So this is just to kind of warm up that right leg a little bit. Right leg's already going to be warmer than when we started on the other side, because every time we do a leg series, we're still using both legs, even if we're just focusing on one. Beautiful. Little bend to the knees, right? Because you want to keep the tension in the back of the legs. We take it down into the squat hold in four, three, two, one. Take it down into your squat hold. So we go right into that skater, drive through the heels. Make sure the knees are right over the ankles. Left leg presses out. Two, three, four, you pull in. Two, three, and four. Keep that distance in between the carriage and the platform. Drive through that right heel. So we really start feeling that magic in your whole right side body as you press out. Turn the toes in, press the heels out, right? That's part of the magic here, is that you're gonna be a little bit pigeon-toed. We drive through that right heel. Beautiful. Little bit of distance, you press out. Two, three, four. Gorgeous, press it in. We keep that distance. You want to keep that constant tension no matter what we're working, right? Whatever body part we're working, right now it's those outer glutes. You want to drive that right heel into that front platform. Press it out. Two. Start feeling that left oblique ignite as you press in. Gorgeous. Take yourself down into that squat just a little bit deeper. Use the high bars if you need them. Gorgeous. Press it in. Two, three, four. You press out. Awesome. Drive through that right heel. Coming into your final few four counts left. We come into that runner's lunge. We'll turn and face the front. Can you hang on for 15 more seconds? And can you sit it down just one more inch as you press it out? Two, three, and four. You pull in. Gorgeous. We turn and face the front. Two 90-degree angles for runner's lunge. Right foot's going to be underneath that platform strap. Left foot's going to be in the front eyelet. In four, in three, two, one. So setting yourself up on the machine. Left foot is either going to be at the front of the carriage or it's going to be pressed into your carriage strap if you have one. Press into that. Right leg comes to 90. Right leg stays at 90. Drive through your right heel. Left leg presses out for one. Out two, three, four, beautiful. Pull it in. Knees stop right underneath the hips. That's where your knee is going to stop. And then you press out. Two, three, four. Notice that your right heel is always connected to that front platform. So sometimes we have a tendency to press into the ball of the foot. Our heel lifts, and then we get into our calf. You drive through that heel, right? So that the knee is right over the ankle, and you get right into the back of that leg. Gorgeous. Present out. Two, three, four. Use those high bars to ground down through that upper body. Drive through that right heel. Sit yourself down just one more inch. Gorgeous. Slow four count with that left leg. Feel it all the way up through your left oblique. Two 90-degree angles will hold together in four, three, two, one. Just hold those two 90-degree angles. Driving through that right heel. Sit yourself down just one more inch. Beautiful. You'll press out in three, in two, and one. It's out for one, two, three, four. Beautiful. Pull it in. Stay nice and square. Oh, yeah. Coming into push-ups. Feet are going to go into the back eyelets. Hands will come to the high bars. We got push-ups. Little heavy upper body. In four, three, two, and one. Close that carriage up. Take your feet into the back eyelets. So you have two options, kneeling or flying. Stay on your knees, press the carriage out. Option one, take it down, and then press it up, right? There's your option one. Arms are coming to 90, you press back up. Option two, you press those feet into the eyelets, lift the feet, lift the knees off the carriage, take it down. Two, three, four, you press up. Little bend to the elbows. Take it down. Two, three, four. Press up. Little bend into those elbows. So kneeling or flying, that's going to be entirely up to you. As you press up, heart rate will spike a little higher if you choose to stay flying the entire time. That's up to you, right? Sneaking in a little more heavy upper body. Beautiful. So you'll have a nice combination of everything. Gorgeous. Nice job, guys. Coming into a spring change. It's going to be one yellow spring. We start on the left oblique. Left foot's in front of the right. We come into teaser. In four, in three, in two, and one. Close the carriage up. One yellow spring. Teaser on the left. Hands come to the high bars. Left foot crosses in front of the right. Little bend to the elbows. Press the carriage out for one, two, squeeze the inner thighs, three, and four. You lift up. Let the left oblique take you up and in. Give that little squeeze through the inner thighs so that you're getting into that lower core. Pressing out, lifting. Beautiful. As you come in, right, you want to make sure that you get distance in between the carriage and the platform. Lifting. Gorgeous. Pressing out. Nice. Feel that left oblique lift. Squeeze through the inner thighs as you press out. Heels are going to lift. Hands are coming down to that front platform. It's snake. In four, in three, in two, and one. So heels lift, hands come down. Once you're here, nice seamless transition, right? Little bend into the elbows, knees bend in towards your left, towards your right elbow, and you press back out. Let the left oblique take you up and in. Squeeze through the inner thighs. Feel that lower core working. Knees stop underneath the hips. Pressing out. Beautiful. Squeeze through those inner thighs. Feel that lower core. Little bend into those elbows. Pressing out. Beautiful. In. Two. Three. Four. Press out. Two. Three. And four. Hang on here. You have 10 seconds. Forearms come down. Knees come down. Kneeling oblique crunch. In three. Two. And one. So, knees come down, forearms come down, kneeling oblique crunch, knees are turned towards your right elbow, press out, hold here, elbows, shoulders align, now you lift up, two, that's your pace, three, four, press out, two, three, four, beautiful, lift, nice job guys, knees stop right underneath the hips, press it out. Two, three, four. Gorgeous. So you want some distance in between the carriage and the platform. Press down through the forearms. Let the forearms be parallel to each other so that the lats and triceps, everything lights up together. Beautiful. Little squeeze through the inner thighs, right? Just to get into that lower core. Don't just make it about the left oblique. You want to make it about as much total body as possible in every single move that you do here. We go into a crunch-saw combo for the last 20 seconds in four, in three, two, one. Press out, hinge from the shoulders. One, two, three, four. You pull in. Two, three, four. You lift up. Knees stop underneath the hips. Pressing out, hinge out from the shoulders, pull it in, gorgeous, hands come to the high bars, teaser on the right, right foot crosses in front of the left, in three, two, and one, so hands come to the high bars, this time right foot's going to cross in front of the left, little bend into the elbows, you take it out, two, three, four, beautiful. Zip up and in through those inner thighs. Let your right oblique take you. Take it out. Two, three, four, lift up. Beautiful. A little bit of distance in between the carriage and the platform. As you press, lifting up and in. Feel that squeeze through the inner thighs. Pressing out. Gorgeous. Let the right oblique lift. Two, three, and four. Gorgeous. Hands are coming down in a few short seconds. We go into snake. Nice. In four, three, two, one. Extra points if you keep that carriage open. Take the hands down. Little bend to the elbows. Knees bend in underneath the hips. Knees stop there. You press out. Two, three, before you pull in. Squeeze through the inner thighs. Let the right oblique take you. Little bend into those elbows. Shoulders down and back. It's in 2, 3, 4. Gorgeous. Pressing out. Keep it slow. Keep it controlled. Awesome. Forearms are coming down in a few short seconds. This is our toughest oblique exercise, right? Feeling nice and strong here. Forearms come down. Shins come down. It's a kneeling oblique crunch. In 4, in 3, 2, and 1. So bring the forearms down. Bring the knees down. They turn towards your left elbow. Press out into that kneeling twisted plank hold. You go into the crunch for 1, 2, 3, 4. Knees stop right underneath the hips. You press out. 2, 3, 4. Beautiful lift. Feel that lift up and in. Pressing out. Gorgeous. Press out through those forearms, right? Let the lats and triceps ignite. It's a press. It's a lift. Feel the squeeze through the inner thighs. Pressing out. 2, 3, 4. Beautiful. Nice. You know we'll finish this off with that saw crunch combo. Gorgeous. I'll count us into that saw. In 4, 3, 2, and 1. Press out. Hold now. Hinge from the shoulders. 1, 2, 3, 4. You pull in. You crunch up. Knees stop underneath the hips. You press it out. 2, 3, 4. You hinge out. Gorgeous. Awesome. Lifting up. Short little arm series. We got 3 yellow. You're going to grab those black cables for some bicep curls. In 3, 2, and 1. So close that carriage up. 3 yellow springs. Grab your black cables. You're going to start in a bicep curl. So we start. Arms up. Hold here. Shoulders are down and back. We'll press out together. Elbow, shoulder stay aligned. In 4. In 3, in 2, and 1. You press out. 2, 3, and 4. A little bend to the elbows. Take it right back into 90. Gorgeous. Pressing out. Now, what you'll notice, right, in our warm-up, we did push-ups. So when we went into that catfish, we got the push-ups. Beautiful. Take a hold in 3, in 2, and 1. Hold here. Nice. Press it up an inch, down an inch, up an inch, down an inch. Then full range in 3, in 2, and 1. Press it out. Super slow workout. We did some heavy upper body with our push-ups and our chest press in between those legs. Beautiful. We go into sexy back. Elbows are going to come right behind the shoulders. It's a tricep extension in 3, in 2, and 1. So take it behind you. Elbows, shoulders aligned. You're slightly elevated off of the heels. You press back. 2, 3, and 4. A little bend to those elbows. Take it in right to 90. Press. The press, especially towards the front of the room, feel your core light up. Press it out. 2, 3, and 4. Little bend into those elbows, right? Because you don't want to lock the arms out. Let that core lift you up and in. Beautiful. We take a hold in 3, in 2, and 1. Press back, hold, little bend into those elbows. Nice. We're going to pulse it out. Take it down an inch, up an inch, down an inch. Up an inch. Gorgeous. We finish out full range in 3, in 2, and 1. Bend it in. Gorgeous. Press it out. We'll drop those cables. We'll come into a reverse plank hold. Feet on the front platform. Hands on the sides of the carriage. In 3, in 2, and 1. Drop those cables. 1 yellow spring only. Take those feet to the front platform. Take those hands to the sides of your carriage. You press out. Beautiful. We'll take a reverse bear in 3, in 2, and one. Knees bend in, super slow, four count, knees stop underneath the hips. Press it out. Two, three, and four. That's your pace. Press it in. Gorgeous. Nice. You are coming towards the last few seconds of class, right? So hang on here. We press out into a plank in three, in two, and one. Press out into your plank. Hold. Nice. Now, don't let that carriage close. Bring the forearms down to the front of your carriage. Hold a forearm plank for the last 15 seconds, or take an army crawl. Crawling to number nine, crawling back to number three. You have 10 seconds left. Stay nice and strong. You guys did awesome. We'll take a quick child's pose in four, in three, in two, and one. Take the knees on the front platform. Take them as wide as possible. Press your hands into the carriage. Just let it all go. Take your child's pose. Breathe it in. Releasing it out. Let it all go. Beautiful. Awesome job, guys. As always, thank you so much for joining me today. We'll see you guys again soon. If you have any questions, as always, feel free to send us an email.